everyone. This is Anushree.
And this is Medha. And we, on behalf of the Beaming Notes team, can't thank you enough for your overwhelming support over the past few years.
It is because of your love and appreciation that we have been able to launch our very own YouTube channel.
And we need your support this time as well.
So go ahead, hit that subscribe button and show us some love.
And now, let's head over to the video.
Hey everybody, welcome to Beaming Notes. And today we're going to look at the summary of the poem After Blenheim by Robert Southey. Summary, stanza 1. It was a summer evening, old Kasper's work was done, and he before his cottage door was sitting in the sun, and by him sported on the green his little grandchild, Wilhelmine. The first stanza begins with a picturesque description of a summer evening. The poet introduces the main character of the poem. Old Kasper had just finished his work for the day and was sitting in the sun before his cottage door, watching his granddaughter Wilhelmine play on the field. Summary stanza 2. She saw her brother Peterkin roll something large and round, which he beside the rivulet in playing there had found. He came to ask what he had found that was so large and smooth and round. While playing, Wilhelmine saw her brother Peterkin rolling something large, smooth and round which he had found beside the stream. He was curious to know what that thing was and turned to his grandfather for information. Summary, stanza 3. Old Kasper took it from the boy who stood expectant by. And then the old man shook his head and with a natural sigh, "'Tis some poor fellow's skull," said he, "who fell in the great victory." Old Kasper took the large and smooth and round thing from his grandson's hand and shook his head with a sigh as he figured that it was some poor fellow's skull who had died in the war. It is ironic that he refers to the Battle of Blenheim as a great victory at the cost of loss of human lives. Summary, stanza 4. I find them in the garden, for there's many hereabout, and often when I go to plough, the ploughshare turns them out. For many thousand men, said he, were slain in that great victory. Kasper goes on to mention that he had found many such skulls while ploughing the land, as thousands of soldiers were killed in the victorious war. The dead bodies of these soldiers lie in these fields unnoticed. However, Kasper's use of term great victory expresses his pride at the sacrifice of the soldiers who played a vital role in the war. Summary, stanza 5. Now tell us what it was all about. Young Peterkin, he cries, and little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder-waiting eyes. Now tell us all about the war and what they fought each other for. The children were excited to know more about the war. They were curious to know about the purpose of the war. They had associated a sense of thrill, adventure and excitement with the idea of war and sacrifice. Little Wilhelmine looked up to her grandfather in anticipation with wonder-waiting eyes. In this stanza, the poet attempts to distinguish the kind of curiosity and enthusiasm associated with a child. Summary, stanza 6. It was the English, Kasper cried, who put the French to rout. But what they fought each other for, I could not well make out. But everybody said, quoth he, that was a famous victory. The Battle of Blenheim was one of the major battles of the War of Spanish Succession, in which the English successfully defeated the Franco-Bavarian army. Kasper takes pride in the great victory, but he is unable to tell his grandchildren the reason behind the war. He did not even try to find the purpose behind it. He just chose to know what others told him regarding the war, that it was a famous victory. Summary, stanza 7. My father lived at Blenheim then, yon little stream hard by. They burned his dwelling to the ground, and he was forced to fly. So with his wife and child he fled, nor had he where to rest his head. In this stanza, we observe Kasper recollecting the memories of his past. He tells the children that his father used to live at Blenheim. The French soldiers burned homes of several innocent people, among which was his father's. This destruction forced the people to leave the village in search for a safer place. Kasper's father thus fled with his wife and young Kasper in search for shelter, but he was unable to find a home because of the dreadful war. This rendered their family homeless. Summary, stanza 8. With fire and sword the country round was wasted far and wide, and many a childing mother then and newborn baby died. But things like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. Stanza 8 highlights the horrific aspect of wars. The symbol of fire and sword embodies the evil spirit of human cruelty and destruction. The image of the death of pregnant mothers and newborn babies heightens the idea of ruination of human beings caused by none other than men themselves. The idea is to express how thousands of innocent lives are taken in due course of a futile and meaningless war that is sure to bring only damage and destruction. The irony in the poem is made evident by Kasper, as he says that these things are meant to happen at every battle where there is a great victory. Summary, stanza 9. They say it was a shocking sight after the field was won, for many thousand bodies here lay rotting in the sun. But things like that, you know, must be after a famous victory. The poet through Kasper goes on to describe the agony of war. He mentions the shocking sight of the battlefield that was full of dead bodies of the soldiers rotting in the sun. Through this image, the poet attempts to bring into consideration the indignity in the way the soldiers lay. They are reduced to a mere status of an inanimate object. There is no dignity, no glory in war, only misery. Even after such terrifying aspect of the war, Kasper regards it as a famous victory, which emphasizes on the ignorance of the old man about the purpose and consequence of war. Summary, stanza 10. Great praise the Duke of Marlborough won, and our good Prince Eugene. Why it was a very wicked thing, said little Wilhelmine. Nay, nay, my little girl, quoth he, it was a famous victory. Duke of Marlborough was an English general. He was the commander of the British forces in the Battle of Blenheim. Prince Eugene and Duke of Marlborough represented Britain and defeated the French at Blenheim. Kasper sang praises for men who brought the famous victory to the nation, but Wilhelmine, confused at the meaningless praises, exclaims that the war was a wicked thing. For the first time in the poem, we see a disapproval of the false glory of war. But shutting the little child, Kasper goes on to repeat the same thing. The war for him is not a wicked thing as long as it is a famous victory. Summary, stanza 11. And everybody praised the Duke who this great fight did win. But what good came of it at last, quoth little Peterkin. Why, that I cannot tell, said he, but it was a famous victory. Kasper boasts of the Duke for having won the war for them. Innocent Peterkin asks his grandfather, what good comes out of such misery? Old Kasper is unable to answer the question of the child. All he can say is that it was a famous victory. This remark heightens the sense of irony in the poem, as in spite of such cruelties and casualties, the old man sticks to his illogical belief that the war brought victory to them. Central idea. After Blenheim is an anti-war poem that is set in the background of the famous Battle of Blenheim in 1704. This poem brings into consideration the tragic consequences of war. The poet employs the character of an old man and his grandchildren to reflect on the horrors and drudgery of war, like loss of lives, burned houses, rotting corpses, and civilian casualties, like those pregnant women and newborn babies. Although old Kasper realizes the damage caused by the war, he repeatedly uses terms like famous victory, great victory to describe the outcome of the war. The gruesome descriptions of the war followed by the grandfather's pride in it shows how a common man is cut off from the politics and futility of wars. In the old man's praises embody an ordinary citizen's inability to realize the meaninglessness of the great victory. The children, who are unable to grasp the essence of the praises for the war heroes, seem to ridicule old Kasper's unconcerned attitude as they become the poet's mouthpiece, who expresses his disapproval of the disservice of wars. Conclusion. After Blenheim, also called Battle of Blenheim, was written during Southey's Jacobean years. Critics often explain this poem as the most celebrated of British anti-war poems. It is also important and should be mentioned that after 22 years of after Blenheim, Southey changed his pacifist view of the war, and he said that the Battle of Blenheim was the greatest victory which had ever done honor to British arms.
So, did you find the video helpful? If so, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and continue to encourage us more to deliver more such poem analysis and English language tips to help you to get set and ready for your examinations. All the best.